This episode is relating to foreign trade. When you say foreign trade, it is inclusive of exports as well as imports. When you sell the indigenous product in any of the foreign countries across the borders of India, it can be termed as export. And if you buy any product, exotic product, that is for products available in the foreign countries, if you are buying that product, those products into India, then it is import. Import, export, both are collectively called as foreign trade or international trade. There is a tremendous potential in India, both for export as well as for import. As a trainer, I used to suggest all the participants to focus only on exports and not to imports. Because by doing exporting, the exporter is also getting so many benefits besides his profit. By selling the product to foreign countries, the government is giving so many incentives. And when you go for importing a product from a foreign country, you have to send your money, in other terms it is our government's money, to foreign country. So by doing exporting, our economy is growing. By doing import, our economy is declining. So I used to tell other participants to focus only on export, not on import. If at all they are more interested to go for import, initially ask them to venture into export and succeed the issue, and then try for importing. So this is the actual situation. The growth of any country or the economic development of any country in the whole world is mostly decided by the international trading situations of each and every country. In India, our export is always lesser than the volume of importing. By exporting, we are getting the foreign funds into our country. Our exchequer is getting plenty of foreign funds by way of collecting American dollar or international, ruble from Russia, pound sterling from England, or so many countries are having their own different kinds of money or currency. To the best of my knowledge, I understand that more than 32 countries in the world are having their currency in the name of dollar. American dollar, Canadian dollar, Hong Kong dollar, Singapore dollar, Australian dollar, it goes on like this. Likewise, Indian currency, we call it as rupee, Indian rupee. Indian currency is rupee, but rupee is the name of the currency in 8 foreign countries. For example, Sri Lanka or Indonesia or Mauritius or Maldives or Seychelles. These countries are also having their currency in the name of rupee. So that is why we are calling our rupee as INR, Indian rupee, Sri Lankan rupee, and so on. International trade, doing export or import, is a very interesting issue. If a person is interested to venture into export, he can do it very simply following so many guidances or so many prevailing situations. He should try to understand, he should get trained, he should get the license, and so on. Doing exporting is comparatively easier than doing local business, domestic trade. So in India, the number of international traders are extremely very much less. It is astonishing to note that being a largest country, both on the basis of population and on the basis of geographical growth, India is extremely lagging behind in terms of international trade. Very small countries in the globe are doing much more quantum of international trade than our country. For example, if you take it to Singapore, Singapore is a very small country, very, very, very small country. Comparing to India, it is very, very small. You can take Singapore or you can take Hong Kong or even you can take Japan, so many countries. Most of the world countries are very much smaller in size than India. But India's international trade extremely is much lesser than most of the small countries in the globe. So there is a tremendous opportunity for venturing into international trade, both as an exporter as well as an importer. Entering import, if you have the idea of entering into foreign trade, there are several issues. What you need? What are your requirements? You need heavy investment, we need much of qualification, you need to know the actual rules, regulations, so many things. You may think like that, but practically speaking, these are all very simple. For example, if you like to start a very small business in the local market, for example, if you are starting a bank shop, you need at least 50,000 to 1 lakh amount of investment. But it is quite surprising that in most of the cases, international traders, especially the exporters, are venturing and succeeding with very much less investment or even without investment. It is possible. As a trainer, I can tell you so many examples, thousands and thousands of examples. Most of our trainers have succeeded in international trade exporting without their own investment. That means they are getting the order from the foreign buyers along with the payment in advance. So that's why they don't need to invest their own money. So without investment, there is possibility for succeeding in export. And most of all, a beginner in exporter may not be able to get high value of order from any importer from any country. As a trial basis, then a beginner importer will give you a very small order, and that very small order, even if you are not able to get the advance payment from the buyer, you can make it with your own lesser investment. It is possible. When you grow up your level, there may be possibility that you will be able to get payment in advance from the importer. In case the importer is not favorable to give you the order with payment in advance, he can prefer to go for giving the order along with the letter of credit, LC. LC is a guarantee letter for payment to the exporter by the importer's bank on behalf of the importer. So in that case, by getting LC, you are getting the guarantee of collecting the payment when the products are shipped to the buyer. When you get the order along with the LC, pledging the LC in your bank, you can get financing facility from the import, from the local banker to execute the order. So as a trainer, I used to advise most of our participants to go for either advance payment or on LC basis, and I advise them not to go for getting payment in a risky manner. So investment is not a big question when you venture into export. Another thing is getting license. Today, getting license in export trade has become extremely easier. You cannot imagine. It may be unbelievable. It is absolutely true. By just paying just 500, sitting in your home, you can apply the license online, and it will come to your door in a matter of few minutes. So getting the license is extremely easier now. Rest of the issues we will continue in the next episode.